Oh, we'll get into the, Frank has got some fabulous desserts on the desk. We'll get into those a little later. This is no dessert. It's every modern dater's worst nightmare. Catfishing. Here comes Neve Schulman. Neve, nice to see you. And here's my question. You've had great success with the show for 8 years or more. In a way, the success of the show, wouldn't that lessen the incidences of catfishing?
You know, you'd think that by now everyone would be familiar with the idea that you never really know who you're talking to online and to be careful. But for a lot of reasons, not the least of which is quarantine, people are looking for and willing to get into virtual relationships now more than ever.
And the fact that we are quarantined, I suppose, if you're a little sketchy, well, she's never going to find out anyway. I might as well tell her I'm a pro basketball player or whatever.
Well, yeah, no, it's funny because normally people have to come up with these wild excuses why they can't meet up or travel to sort of find each other. But now everyone has the perfect excuse, unfortunately, which is that no one's going anywhere. So I think just in the last 6 months alone, a lot of people have, because of boredom and isolation, made these fake profiles, whether it started off as a way to get back at someone or do some research on an ex or maybe enact revenge on a scorned lover. I mean, whatever the reason, now there are these additional people out there, you know, intermingling and going on the dating sites and posting on Facebook and creating these new connections. And we've seen a few of them pop up in this new season already.
Here's the thing. We looked at all your socials. Beautiful wife, beautiful children, lovely, normal family. And yet this work that you do is the antithesis of that. Do you find that unusual?
You know, it's funny. I constantly remind myself that it was 12 years ago now, that I was a young person online who got involved in a relationship with someone who ended up being very different than who they had said they were. And so I think everybody, whether you're young or old, has to go through that learning experience. You know, some of us are lucky and we end up finding love in real life. But even still, a lot of people now, dating online is just where you do it. And whether it's an in-person date and someone lies to you and you have to learn the hard way that not everyone tells the truth, or it's online, you kind of have to go through the motions. Looking for love is tough.
All right, we're going to look at a clip, and what I want to tell people as you look at this is watch the computer screens on your television screen, because this gentleman, type out almost immediately, this guy's a fake. Take a look.
You did try to see him in Detroit or something?
I was in Detroit. I got stuck there. It's like an 11-hour layover. I had to hit him up. He was on his way over with his friend, and he said his friend's car broke down. I was annoyed. Because I told him, I said, you keep making excuses all the time. So I said to him, you know, I'm not going to keep doing a long distance relationship. I think that you should move to LA.
Obviously in capital letters. When these folks get busted on the show, what happens?
Well, that's interesting. You know, normally on the show, we show up at their house and we force them to have the in-person interaction that they should have done years or months earlier. In this case now, all we can really do is offer them our Zoom meeting room ID and hope that they'll click the link and finally reveal themselves, which is something they should have also done previously. So it's interesting because everyone brings a very different energy. Sometimes, you know, they'll join the Zoom and it'll just be a shot like this and you won't really be able to see their face. And we have to convince them to lower the camera to finally show themselves. So we really don't know what we're going to get. People are home, obviously, which I think gives them a little bit more of a sense of comfort, which strangely also then gives them permission, I think, to say and act in a way that they might not in person. So it's very strange. It's definitely changed the expectations from our end of what we're going to get every time, you know, we meet some new person on the show.
Chance for folks to watch it at home. Catfish, the TV show, Wednesday nights on MTV. Neve, really nice to talk to you today. Thanks so much.
Thanks so much.
There you go. From New York, Neve, Jess and Frank, across the way to...